his training, and he's training at Mayweather's gym.
Is he?
Yeah. What do you say about that?
Good for him. You know, he has a big following. People love him. People want to see him. So I wouldn't mind seeing him also, you know. You know, see how he comes back after like 5 years.
So
interesting.
He comes back at 54, right?
I don't know. Unless Arisa could make him come down to 147 again for his first fight.
Watching him in the mitts, it looks like he's still hitting very hard.
He's always going to have power.
Now, you mentioned a second ago that you think Mikey's going to take Spence's body shots.
I think so. Mikey's ready for whatever Spence brings, honestly. Mikey's ready. He's been looking so good in training. And
yesterday, 10 rounds with big guys.
And I know the fight's not going to be any difference. I think Mikey's got what it takes. I think he does.
And then I talked to Oscar De La Hoya yesterday, and he says he's rooting for Mikey, but he thinks the size difference.
Right. Well, look, he should know better, you know. He had the size over Pacquiao, right?
Yeah.
But, you know, a lot of people think that. You know, I'm not going to argue with Oscar. Oscar's a great fighter, great person. But you know, a lot of people think like that too. You know, a lot of people do think like that. But inside the ring, it's going to be a different story. Mikey's going to go do his work.
And Sugar Ray Leonard said, I asked him why. He said, because it's Mikey.
And that's true.
Hey, where's Frank the Cook? That's his next t-shirt.
It's because it's Mikey.
That's the next t-shirt
because it's Mikey. Why? It. Because it's Mikey.
And on the bottom, Sugar Ray Leonard.
Yeah.
That's your favorite fighter, right?
My favorite fighter of all times.
So let's talk about
best fighter of all time.
So you went to a funeral this morning, Okwate.
Oh yeah, Sugar Land, huh? Roy Jones was badass. Roy Jones was fucking. I was.
He was a little better than Sugar Ray, wasn't he?
I still pick Sugar Ray, but Roy Jones was fucking badass. Skills wise, I think at 160, Roy Jones would have played with Triple G. What do you think?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
All right, good.
Back in Roy's day, there wasn't nobody to touch him.
This morning you went to a funeral.
Yeah, since last night I went. You know, because they had the services last night, and this morning the burial.
A lot of people came.
Yeah, a lot of people showed up.
A lot of old friends,
yeah. You know, from Colonia, from the neighborhood. You know, they were all there. It was sad. It was sad, you know, that we get to see each other in that situation, but it was also good to see so many old friends from back in the gym from 20, 30 years ago.
We all know Jim. You said he lived here even. He lived in...
Yeah, he lived here for a couple of years, you know, helping us out right here with the guys, you know, obviously trying to stay out of trouble. I try to, you know, we did, you know, he's like my little brother. We try to help him out in as much as we can, you know. You know, he's like my brother. You know, he's 2 years younger, 3 years younger than me, but, you know, he's like my brother. Him and Jordy have been my friends since we were growing up in the gym.